Consciousness is defined as the state of being awake and aware of one's surroundings. It's the mind's understanding that it exists, and it's one of the most elusive phenomena in all of human understanding. Not a surprise. To try and shed light on this mystery, scientists are searching for a biological explanation that they call the neural correlates of consciousness, which means the parts of your brain that supposedly generate self-awareness. And they may have found a key component. Researchers at the Allen Institute for Brain Science uncovered 3 giant neurons, one of which is projected across the cortex of a mouse brain like a crown of thorns. They've traced these special neurons to what's believed to be one of the most densely connected parts of the brain called the claustrum. Scientists have hypothesized that the claustrum could be coordinating all sorts of inputs and outputs to create the conscious experience. So seeing these 3 giant neurons extend from the claustrum, kind of a big deal. The claustrum is a tiny sheet of neurons just below the cortex, and there's one on each hemisphere of the brain. Scientists suspect the claustrum is a highly integrated region and could have more anatomical connections than any other part of the brain. It's potentially connected to many cortical areas that are crucial for perception, vision, movement, and hearing. When studying the region, famous neuroscientist Francis Crick, yes, one of the guys that discovered the structure of DNA, proposed that subjective consciousness is possible thanks to the claustrum, which could be acting as some kind of conductor in the mind. For instance, if your brain were an orchestra, he suspected the claustrum would be responsible for keeping the myriad pieces and instruments playing together. Crick explained this orchestration concept best when he described the experience of picking a rose. You can hold the rose in your hand, you can smell its fragrance, you can see its red petals, and your mind processes this as a unified subjective experience. The thing is, the claustrum conductor, that's a hypothesis. But there was a recent study that did give brain scientists pause. In 2014, there was a woman with epileptic seizures who underwent deep brain stimulation. They put electrodes over her left claustrum and stimulated them. She immediately stopped what she was doing and she stared blankly into space. She didn't even respond to calls or gestures. When they turned off the stimulation, she regained consciousness and didn't remember what happened. It was almost like they discovered an on-off switch deep inside of her brain. That's crazy. The claustrum could be the key to figuring all this out, but we don't know for sure because consciousness is considered the ultimate enigma. Looking for connections in the brain, that isn't enough to explain whether consciousness is actually present. It's way more complicated than that. Some of the biggest minds in physics think that consciousness is something that the brain won't ever solve, but we'll leave that for philosophers and scientists to fight over. What do you guys think? We can't do episodes like this without our sponsors. Thanks to Graze for sponsoring this episode. Graze makes snacking exciting by combining wholesome ingredients with flavors that we all love to create over 100 nutritionist-approved snacks. Go to graze.com and enter promo code SEEKER to get a free sampler box delivered to your home or work. Now, there's a lot we still need to learn about the brain, but one of the burning questions that we all have is, could you survive with only half of one? Julian has the answer on that here. Thanks for watching Seeker. Don't forget to subscribe so you get more videos from us, and come follow us on Facebook and Twitter.